Yeah, I mean, on the grant in aid question, which I think in many ways from the standpoint of those of us that were arguing against the federal law and on the limited government side of this, it is the one victory out of this, even though it's not a victory in terms of the statute itself, longer term it is. I mean, starting with the New Deal, the court had essentially said, we're going to allow Congress under its commerce power to regulate extremely broadly. Some of the early cases, like Wickard and Filburn, you know, suggested that perhaps there was no limit. Plenary was the term that the court used in that case. Then you saw coming up through the Great Society programs into the 70s, into the 80s, you saw the court start to at least pay lip service to the notion that there are limits, but they didn't find anything to strike down. Well, there are limits, but the case in front of us doesn't cross that line. Then, in the post-Reagan years, when you started to get some more conservative, federalism-minded justices on the court, you started to see these isolated cases where the court struck down grant in aid provisions, but did so saying, the court upheld grant in aid provisions, but did so with increasingly strong language saying there are limits. The most dramatic of those was South Dakota versus Dole, which is the underage 18-year-old alcohol case where the federal government said we're going to withhold 5% of your transportation money to states unless you enact this 18-year-old drinking age. And the court said 5% was not too big a club to cross the constitutional line. What the court said today in the majority opinion that I thought was striking, the court referenced the Dole case. And the court said, in the Dole case, we declined to identify where that line is, how much coercion is too much. But clearly, 5% withholding of federal highway money did not cross the line. What we're saying today is we are still declining to draw a bright line and tell you how much is too much, but we're saying that a 100% withholding of Medicaid money does cross the line. So we now have a case that is outside the boundaries. We know the boundary lies somewhere between Dole and HHS in Florida, and I suspect we'll be litigating this case again, we writ large states. Yeah. We'll be litigating this case again, this question again, going forward, but we've started to narrow the spectrum. And I think that's good news long-term from the standpoint of those of us who think that there ought to be judicial limits as well as just political limits on the ability of the federal government to tax spend and impose its will by offering to pay states.